Victoria Beacon Hill.
Madam Speaker, I cannot believe that I heard the minister actually say that there are comprehensive services for children and youth with mental health in this province. There have been reports after reports after reports that have pointed out there are not comprehensive services, and we are going to continue to speak out to respect those youth in British Columbia. Madam Speaker, the representative makes it very clear that this young woman is facing many of the same challenges that Paige faced. She makes it clear that the BC Liberals have not done enough to make life better for youth like that. She says, and I quote, "A year after Paige's story was released, the representative is discouraged that the work done to profile this cohort of vulnerable young people has not yet translated into action." Honourable Speaker, I've heard this minister talk about changes being made. I've heard those words over and over and over and over again from this government. Those words are hollow to the youth who are not getting the care that they need and they deserve. To the minister, why has she not implemented fully the Page report?
Minister for Children and Family Development.
Well, Madam Speaker, again, I guess they weren't listening, Madam Speaker, because, Madam Speaker, there has been a lot of work since the Page report. In fact, we went beyond the recommendations of the Page report in implementing the rapid response model in the downtown east side so that we could better coordinate services, so that we could make sure that that if there were improvements to be made, that those recommendations on what was needed could come up. But, Madam Speaker, this is not news. To the fact that there are vulnerable children and youth living on the downtown east side, that the fact that it in fact acts as a magnet for some children and youth with high needs and high risk behaviors, Madam Speaker, is not news to us nor to all of the service providers and frontline workers in the ministry. Madam Speaker, it is a reality in our society. It is something that they work with every day, working with those youth, trying to connect them to services, to have them step forward and say, yes, I want to accept that help, Madam Speaker. It is about being there. It is about repeating and repeating and repeating the offers of support, earning the trust of those youth, Madam Speaker. And our workers are doing that every day. As a result of the Page report, we did a comprehensive review of over 120 kids in the downtown east side, looking specifically to ensure both their safety and what, if anything, could be done differently, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Minister.
And I said earlier in my answers, Madam Speaker, we know what steps need to be taken. We know where the gaps are, Madam Speaker, and I will have more to say on enhanced services in the next couple of days.
Victoria Beacon Hill on a supplemental.
Well, Madam Speaker, it should be news and it should be discussed every single day when we are failing children in care in this province. Let's remember, Honourable Speaker, this is the government that got rid of the independent office for children and youth. This is the government that cut services and cut supports for vulnerable children. So excuse us if we don't always believe this government when they talk about supporting children and youth. Action be promised before. And what have we seen? We've seen nothing done to support vulnerable youth, to make sure that they don't age out without supports and without homes. We haven't seen a discussion begin around secure care. We see a rapid response team that's in place with no resources, no new resources to actually help youth. So, Honourable Speaker, once again, how many youth are going to fall through the cracks before this minister and this government will actually act for them?
Minister of Children and Family Development.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker. And so that the member understands the work on the downtown east side, the rapid response team, in its very first few months of operation, had the opportunity to better connect with youth and ensure that 38 youth were able to access services that they didn't know existed or weren't previously accessing, Madam Speaker. Some returned home to family in other parts of the province. Some accessed mental health supports, medical treatments, got their first government-issued identification. Madam Speaker, the work on the Downtown East Side with youth is complex, it is difficult, and it takes time, Madam Speaker. But the supports that are available are intense. Service providers, government service providers, government offices and supports through MCFD, service providers that offer outreach workers, there's housing options, there are mental health supports, there are health and wellness supports. Madam Speaker, there are plenty of supports and services, and as I said, we will be able to announce shortly some additional supports in that area.